Bonjour les amis, today I'm going to teach you how to do a crème anglaise or thin custard. This recipe is the base and it can be used in many different recipes. You can use with a brownie, you put your crème anglaise around the brownie and it's very nice. You can even put a ice cream on top. Or poached pear is very nice as well. Or the most common one is the eel flottante. But first, I'm Olivier. Professional chef in France and UK. My channel is here to help you to gain confidence in your cooking. To do your crème anglaise or thin custard, what you need a vanilla pod, so that is optional, it's depending on you. 500 g of milk, 125 g of sugar, and 4 egg yolks. So to start, we're going to remove the seed from the pod, from the vanilla pod. So you open your pod in two, and with your knife, so you remove the seed of your vanilla like that, with your knife, and you have all your seed there. So you keep that on the board for now, and this one you put inside the milk to infuse your milk. You're going to put your sugar, your 4 egg yolks, and we need to, as we call in French, blanchir les œufs. So this means you mix together. And see, they are yellow for now, very yellow. But I'm going to accelerate it, and they're starting to become white. So what that means? That means the yellow is starting to cook with your sugar. Now, that is done. So as soon as you finish your blanchir les œufs, you need to add your vanilla seed inside. So I'm going to add all my vanilla seed. As I said, it's very optional. It's up to you if you wanted to add it or not. See how it's nice? All this seed. That is very nice. This is exactly how we want our crème anglaise. So my milk starting to boil, not completely boil. Need to be careful with the milk because the milk is poof, getting out. So I remove my pod, vanilla pod. So my milk is almost boiling now. I'm going to transfer half of the milk inside these preparations because we don't want to overcook your egg. Otherwise, you're going to have plenty of yolk together. It's not going to be nice. So, leave half of my milk and I mix like that, all together, and I put it back in my milk. Voilà. Put it over it. So we don't want this preparations to boil. So how do you know your crème anglaise is cooked? It's very simple. You do in your 8 and your 0. You turn, and when you see it's left a pellicle on top of your wooden spoon, this means it's cooked. For now, it's not cooked yet. We don't want to overcook your crème anglaise. If you overcook, it will be very thick, it will be almost custard. See? you have your wooden stay longer now, so that is cooked. So your custard, your thin custard is cooked now. So I'm going to switch off. And you have your crème anglaise ready to serve. So as I said, crème anglaise can be used with the île flottante. You put your white egg on top or on the brownie. You put your crème anglaise around the brownie with ice cream, vanilla ice cream. It's lovely. Plenty of different uses for this crème anglaise. So, as usual, if you like this recipe, don't forget to push the thumbs up, it helps our channel, subscribe, and if you have any comment, put below, I'm going to reply to you. But for now, I wish you bon appétit, and see you next time!